12 o'clock on a Wednesday, and this is the Wizard Product Review. I'm Dave.
I'm Craig.
And on this week's show.
On this week's show, first up is...
I'm assuming.
Yeah, Welcome to My World.
Welcome to My World by John Stessel. A collection of unique effects.
We're going to have some clips on the screen and that kind of thing. Yeah, John Stessel, first time I heard about this guy was the Lynxus.
Was he Lynxus?
Yeah, his concept, which is why two of the effects on this DVD were on Lynxus.
Okay, now that makes sense.
Because when I watched it, I wasn't sure, and I was like, he's stolen this trick, I'm going to go back and look, and it was like, oh yeah. Fine.
Yeah, because that always goes well.
John Stessel.
Let's have a look at the seven different routines.
Yeah.
Seven different routines. Briefly touch on each one of them. The first one is Icebreaker. I couldn't understand what happened when I had to watch it twice.
I had to watch it three times. Did you?
Yeah.
It's like, first time, it's like... look at my mints.
Basically, he takes some mints, he shakes them, and they change.
Thing is, though, this...
From spearmint to peppermint or something.
This container of mints, have you seen those?
I've never seen it. It must be an American thing.
I think it's an American thing. Not seen them, unfortunately. So, didn't get excited about that one. Next
one. No, it's a very weak trick. Merge, basically, it's a colour change, but you isolate the card that's changing by wrapping it with an elastic band. So, they pick a card... You wrap an elastic band around it, which apparently makes it harder to do. You put it very dodgily on the top of the deck,
up-jogged.
Yeah. You shake it, it changes, and you show it. To me, this is magician's logic. If you're going to do a
colour
change...
There's no live performances on the DVD as well. He's filmed them all in the Roman baths.
Yes, pretty much, yeah. Actually, I agree with that, yeah. If you're going to do a colour change, do a colour change. That's amazing to a layman. You are not going to make it more impressive by wrapping an elastic band around. Maybe for magicians,
but for
that technique to work, you know, what's more impressive? Like just shaking a card and it changing away from the deck, or jogging a card slightly.
Putting it in a sleeve so you can't use sleight of hand, and then slowly it changes and the audience go, wow.
Exactly. Yeah, wow, I like that. Nice link. Yeah, it's just not needed.
Well, it's all right. You might like it. You might like it. Clips
on
the screen.
Probably not. I'm skipping that because that's the best trick on the DVD. Black hole.
We had an argument about this, didn't we?
Yeah, but you bought me around.
You came in today and you were like, I actually quite like black hole. And I was like, really? I thought it was so obvious.
Yeah, having rewatched the DVD, because this was the fourth DVD I watched, I was tired. Having rewatched black hole, I got to agree with you. It is very obvious. Compared to what I thought it was going to be, to be honest, you take a coin, you drop it in a card box, you say you can hear it, right?
I think a lot of the routines on there, apart from that one, that standout effect, you kind of watch it and you kind of go,
but with some of them you don't, like cap off, like what's the point?
Well, cap
he introduces
off.
A new the, concept that's not needed.
The thing is, yeah, he's got a new concept. And this is part of the gimmick that was actually discussed on the Lynxus project.
Mm-hmm.
And he does the popcorn effect on there, which uses exactly the same gimmick, where you've got one piece of popcorn, you go like this, and it shoots straight up into your mouth. And when we reviewed Lynxus, we said that was kind of cool and we liked it.
I do like popcorn.
But the thing is, this cap off effect... He starts the explanation and it says, now let me say up front, it doesn't use this gimmick that rhymes with hoops. It doesn't use this gimmick. And when he did it, I thought, I'm actually quite fooled. No, it doesn't use one of those. It uses just a bigger version.
A bigger version of it, yeah. So he does use one of them. But I don't think that's a selling point to a trick.
No.
You're not going to go up to a layman and go, now, by the way, this doesn't use a double lift. This uses something completely different. Watch this. You're not going to discuss methodology before in front of the spectator before you do it.
I didn't get the trick itself and what it actually offered.
That's not
extra.
A selling point. The fact that it doesn't use a gimmick that does that trick perfectly well is not a selling point to that method. And it looks identical, as just known. And it's a bigger setup than having just something around your wrist.
As a, like Arrow, I can imagine a few of the guys watching this show are going to really like Arrow, which was a new method of flicking the card out.
It did look, going into
the side of the deck.
Nice.
It looked really good. If you like that sort of thing, you might like to learn that move.
Yeah.
I think there's a lot of stuff on here. There's a lot of value for money. Not one of these tricks is worthy of a single trick DVD. So it's right that he's put a collection of ideas onto his DVD.
And he does say at the end...
You can't blame him for that.
And he does say at the end, Welcome to My World doesn't end here. Anybody who buys the DVD, any other tricks that he comes up with or handlings, he's going to send out.
Yeah, he's going to keep you updated.
Yeah, which is nice of him. Now...
bring out another DVD soon, I guess.
The one trick that I think is very, very good, it's not worthy of a single trick, but it's the standout trick on this DVD, is something called Bendable.
Yeah.
Bendable, you take one of those bendy straws that you get from most places, and he goes, watch this. And he just takes the bendy part of the bendy straw and slowly moves it down. Yeah. A bit like Pavel's walking knot that you talked about last week. He slowly moves it down, and then fuses into position at the other end and hands it out for examination.
I'd seen the trick before because Aaron Jones does it. And when Aaron Jones, who brought combustion out with World Magic Shop, when he first contacted us, he wanted to have gimmick straws made with the bendable part right in the middle.
Yeah.
So you would take like a Nando's black straw and you would move the bendable part down to the middle and then it would go into the middle. But we looked into doing it and producing these things. And the straw manufacturers had machines that just kept going and kept going. They were set up a specific way. And we couldn't actually produce it with the bendable part in the middle. But that's what he wanted to do, was actually move the bendable part of the straw. And it would have been great. It would have been a great trick. What John has done here is basically the same effect. And I'm not implying at all that he's not come up with this totally independently, of course, because Aaron hasn't published his idea.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, but John's got it there first.
With his method, it moves down and goes to the opposite end of the straw, but the same distance.
Yeah.
From the end, sort of thing.
And it does look very magical.
It looks really good.
And I can imagine a restaurant performer picking this up and just, you know, kind of setting up. Because you can set, if you work in a restaurant and they've got bendy straws, you can set it up with those straws very, very quickly, very, very easily. And you could be doing that all night long. And I think it would get a great reaction.
So there's a lot of stuff on the DVD. There is a lot of stuff on there. It's good value for money in that sense.
It was a good watch as well. I enjoyed watching it. He's not a dynamic performer.
No live performances.
He does come across as a nice guy, though.
It comes across as a very nice guy, but not one of the tricks on the DVD do I think, I'd really like to do that. And for that reason, I'm going to give it 81%.
Yeah,
lots of ideas.
I'm going to give it 80%. There is a chance that I might work that bendable thing, but it's not on my immediate to-do list. It's nice. I enjoyed watching it, but 80%.
Right, Hug by Nefesh. I got to tell you, when I watched this, it was before you came in, and I forced you to watch this first. I like screamed. I was like, whoa.
Well,
I'll tell you what I screamed, but I was shocked when I saw this effect.
Well, I was looking forward to watching this DVD, because if you've seen the trailer, have you seen the trailer?
I haven't seen the trailer. I just stuck the DVD on. I knew nothing about it.
The trailer makes no sense. You watch the trailer and you think at the end of the trailer, I've got no idea what this DVD is about. You just haven't got a clue. But having now watched it, yeah, it's really freaky. It's really, really weird. It's illusions for close-up.
Well, not really close. It is kind of. Probably the best trick on the DVD is the first hug presentation. And it's kind of like a twisting hand style routine.
Yeah, you know the whole...
A lot of people do that these days, including David Copperfield. Lance Burton's worked it on their specials. But he has a version where he says, like, hug yourself. If I said hug yourself from the front, excuse you, Blammo, you'd look like this. Now, I want you to do the same thing from behind, and we'll put some clips on the screen. He's hugging himself from behind, and then it's hard to describe, but you literally see his arms morph through his body.
It's so weird.
If you're following exactly what he does, it really does look impossible.
It's a nice impromptu thing. You could be just walking around, hey, show me something. Okay, let's do this.
Well, you could be, but I can't.
Oh, that's the problem. Most of the stuff on this DVD, you have to be the right sort of bendable body shape.
You have
to be
a little bit gangly and long, thin arms.
Yeah, like Dynamo would be fine with this.
Yes.
Yeah, he, you know, that...
Nefesh, he's quite a thin guy.
You know that gangly, thin sort of thing? Not I'm saying Dynamo's gangly. Well, I am, actually. I'm saying he's gangly.
You need to be like Chris Cross. Anybody in the UK, you know, Chris would have no problem doing this.
You know what? If Chris Cross is watching this, or if you're a friend
of
Chris,
you should buy this.
You need to buy this. This is right up your street. This is perfect
but,
for you.
Just to test if you could do the effect that you've just seen, I think what you need to be able to do, I just literally can't do it. You need to be able to nearly touch your elbows behind your back.
Yeah.
Otherwise, the angles aren't right.
Yeah. I'd
That'd be
that,
fair
yeah.
to say.
Yeah.
And I wouldn't want anybody to buy the DVD, think that looks brilliant, and then it just doesn't work for them. And they can't get it to work. Because I was excited, but I could not get it to work. I haven't got the expansion.
And the problem is, it doesn't matter how much practice you have at it, you will never be able to do it.
Never.
But there is other stuff like that. You showed me that thing that was really good, where you linked your hands through your leg, and just they melted through your leg.
Yeah, it's kind of like the twisting hand illusion once again, but this time you get down on the floor with a spectator, put one leg in front of you, and you kind of put one hand through your leg, and they copy you.
Yeah.
And then you say, hang on, just adjust yourself slightly. Just adjust your hands. That's it. Right, let's try again. And before they know it, you've got your hands linked together. You come straight through your leg, and they're still locked into their leg. And when they look at it, they have no idea how you did it. There's some bonus material on there, but those two effects, the hug effect, the first one with the arms going through the body, and the one going through the leg, are the best tricks on there. There's ones which are variations of the arm twist.
Yeah.
But again, doing it behind your back, kind of like, oh, if I twist my hand this way. And once again, I find it very hard to get one arm right behind my back and still have a lot of my hand in view, whereas Nefesh doesn't have a problem with that.
You know what? If you could, I mean, you're never going to know before you buy the DVD, unfortunately, but if you were the sort of person that could work this material, I think it would be a great thing to learn, because you're going to be in a situation where it doesn't matter where you are, anytime, anywhere, you can do some really cool stuff impromptu. The trouble is, I reckon probably the higher percentage of people that are buying this DVD aren't going to be able to do it because they're the wrong body shape, or they're not flexible enough, or so on and so forth. But if you can do it, it's killer material.
If I could do that hug, that first thing with the arms going through the body, this would be well in the 90s. But I can't. I just can't do it. So I'm relegated to kind of just marking it on the hands through leg illusion, which was the only other thing I liked, 75%.
If you can do hug, I give it 95%. If you're the right body shape. If you're not, I give it 70%.
Right, so before our next review, we're going to announce another name for lads. Probably one of my favourite close-up magicians in the world
ever,
still living today, is going to be lecturing at Lads this year. Tom Stone. We've been trying to get him for 3 years.
Since Lads began. Every year.
First year we tried to get him. Next year
we contact him and we say, Tom, will you do Lads this year? And he always says, I only do a couple of lectures a year.
Yeah.
And I like to remain exclusive. No, ask me again next year.
Yeah.
Somebody always gets there before us. Well, Tom, we've finally got you.
Where's he from?
Tom's from Sweden.
Sweden.
So we've got Tom Stone coming all the way from Sweden.
And Tom, if you're watching this, just before, Tom, please, please, please lecture on your SpongeBob thing. Have you ever seen it? Of course you have.
It's incredible.
Just it's the single most magical thing in the world. And it uses sponge balls. Go figure. If you haven't seen him do this, it is just...
The reset's something worth seeing, isn't it?
The reset. In the time that you reset your entire illusion show, he's halfway through resetting that trick.
It is fantastic. And he'll be doing other stuff and performing and that kind of thing. If you've never seen Tom Stone work, make sure you come to Lads and see him, because he is an incredible close-up magician.
He's the man.
And his philosophy on close-up magic is just
amazing. He embodies Tommy Wonder. That's why you love him so much. Dave's favourite magician of all time was Tommy Wonder.
Yeah.
And he embodies the same sort of... You feel the same way when you listen to Tom.
It's fantastic. And so we've got Michael Chatelain, who we announced last week.
From France.
And
Tom Stone from Sweden.
Sweden. And all the way from Cleethorpes, we have Tom Wright will be doing a lecture on IT as well. And
I'm very interested in seeing that, because, you know, I've watched him do it, and he's amazing, and he does the most amazing. I'm still scared of IT.
Yeah.
And he tells me that at Lads, he's going to be able to get me to change my mind about IT.
It'd be a lecture.
He said to me,
from beginners to experts.
Yeah, he says that by the time he's finished with me, I'm going to be an IT lover. But I don't know whether
I can believe that. And Tom has got an effect coming out very soon. It's going to be out at Magic Live. It is just incredible.
It's his best thing yet. And if you've seen Tom's DVDs, especially Kinetic, you know, I rave to everybody about Kinetic. The moment that somebody's holding a note and he just goes, and it shoots from his hand to Tom's hand. It's just ridiculous. It's just, think about that. Yeah, he holds it here. Somebody's holding a note, and he stands there and just goes, boop, 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 straight into,
and it shoots.
And
right
his
out.
New effect is better than that.
It is better. It's unbelievable. The rave reviews he's got already from some of the biggest magicians in the world are incredible. But when that's revealed, it'll be out there. And you'll see it first on the Wizard Product Review, because we'll have him on before Magic Live, won't we?
Talking about
To talk about it.
How amazing.
And now, from one extreme to another, we're going to talk about Psychic Bottle Opener right now. And it's nothing to do with mind reading. And it's by the same company, I believe, that brought the pack out with the ring going through. It's the same company, isn't it, John?
Yeah.
Okay. So it's probably incredibly expensive.
Pangu Magic. It is quite expensive.
Oh. Oh, man. It's £95.
Including VAT. And what we've got here is a bottle opener that you can have on your key ring. And what I'll get you to do, Craig, is just put it inside your hand like that. And what I want you to do is believe in the magic. Believe that you can, just in your mind, just start to think ENDB.
Does my mind psychologically rearrange the letters?
ENDB. Psychologically, your mind rearranges the letters. ENDB.
Does feel weird.
And if you just open your hand right now, just open your hand. Look, it's actually started to bend a little bit like that. And if I just rub, there we go. It's still going. Still going. Look at that. Check it out. Look, still going. Still going. A little bit further. And that is 95 quid, ladies and gentlemen. Go on. I know what you're going to say, and I agree with you.
Just it's the same methodology as shift key.
Yeah.
And I think shift key's better.
Well, shift key's a natural object, yeah. Because look at all these I've got on here. I've got normal keys.
Yeah.
I've got all the normal stuff. Well, and I think this makes sense. If you're a barman...
Yeah, perfect. Except for the fact you can't actually use it as a bottle opener.
Well, you can
a couple of times.
It says you can do a few times.
Yeah, but if you're a bar opener, if I went to a guy that worked in the bar and said, I'd like to sell you a bottle opener, you can only use it a few times, what do you think? He'd be like, get lost. You need a bottle opener you can use a million times. So it's a natural object that you can have on your keys. No, not really. I have a key fob, my fabled key fob act that everyone talks to me about. And shift key is on there because it's an incredibly strong piece of magic. That ain't going
well. It's brilliant, isn't it? Because if you're doing metal bending, let's try something else, and you just take that key and put it in their hand, and the key bends. Adam did it on us on the Wizard Product Review in Blackpool.
That's why I bought it, because I felt it.
When you feel it happening, it's incredible. This just, it just doesn't do the same. It's all right, but it's not great because it's not a key.
Mm. I do shift key. I do liquid metal, I do coin vexed.
Yeah.
That's it, and that's all I'm going to carry on doing. This is not as good as shift key. It's the same concept, it's something that bends magically in your hand that you can have on your keychain, but it's not as good as shift key. There's no need or purpose for it. It's not that it's badly produced, it's not that it's a bad prop, it's not that it doesn't work, it's just that there's an alternative out there that's better. And correct me if I'm wrong, shift key is cheaper.
Yeah.
Yes.
Well,
I'm pretty sure it is.
It really is a no-brainer. I'm not going to use it. It's all right. It works, as we've just proven, but not interested.
I have to take shift key into consideration. I'm not even going to rate it. No. The reason I'm not going to rate it is because I don't want anybody to even consider buying
it. That's fair, actually. I'll say the same thing. If you like that type of effect, shift key is far more natural, and the fork's good as well, which I do use. Here it is. We've finally been waiting for it. Richard Sanders Turbo Stick. There it is.
You're taking it completely out of context. You can't just go, oh, here it is. And look, I said last week when we reviewed Ace, I said that Richard Sanders only ever releases quality products that are really, really good. And having watched the whole DVD and having played around with this prop, I completely and totally concur with that statement. This is a great
prop.
My problem with it is it just looks like a bit of plastic. Toy. It's the same problem with all paddles.
You know what your problem
is? It's toy shop magic.
Let me tell you what your problem is.
Not on the Wizard product review.
No, not that problem, a different problem.
Yeah, okay.
This is your thing. You work in corporate high-end markets. They were talking about this on the cafe the other week. They said that we always talk about things having an instant reset because we work in places that require an instant reset. And you've got to take into consideration that it's not
if
just people that are watching
it,
the
I'll
show.
I'll spend an hour preparing for it. Seriously.
Yeah, but in your case, you work mainly in the corporate sector.
Yeah.
You work mainly for people in suits at big banquets and that sort of thing.
Yeah, yeah.
So you would not pull something like this out in a million years.
No.
So you instantly are taking the mick out of it and you don't like it. But here's the thing. There are hundreds of people out there that want a routine that will work for kids. Right, let me tell you where this will work. Because you can't deny, you said yourself, the SpongeBob's routine on the DVD
I thought that was all right.
Yeah.
Well, it's very good. It's got some visual bits and it's all right. But I still don't want to be there at the table.
Right, here we go. Yes or no answers. A family restaurant where there's lots of kids and there's lots of adults and you want to do stuff that works for the kids and they go, oh, yeah, let me show you a trick. Oh, yeah, show it to the kids and stuff like that.
I'm the wrong person. It will work. But at the same time, if you're asking me if it would work for me, no, because I'd be worried about what Dad would say when I'd walk away from the table.
Dad would enjoy this as well.
I want Dad to believe that I'm the greatest magician, even though the kids appreciate it as well.
Yeah, but you know, there's some people that out there, there's a lot of people out there that don't work. They don't care. Their income relies completely on entertaining children and not entertaining adults. They don't care if Dad enjoys the trick or not. It's not about Dad enjoying the trick. It's about the kids enjoying the trick. There's a whole bunch of children's entertainers out there that, you know, right, this is where it'll work. It'll work in a family restaurant. If you go and you do a balloon residency where you're just in a restaurant making balloons, you want to put a little extra magic in there to show the kids, this'll work great. Do you work festivals? Do you work fetes? Do you work outside going around doing close-up magic? You fit this in your pocket, you put a dried marker in there, and this will work absolutely fantastically. You want to do a kids show and you want to do a bit of magic walk around, this works fine. No, it's not going to work for a corporate audience. No, it's not going to work where your clientele is mainly adults. It's not going to work at a wedding. It's not even going to work if you want to do something for the kids at the wedding. You will not pull this out. This is not the sort of thing that you will pull out. But there are a lot of people out there that this will work for.
You do it for kids, yeah. They'll go home and pull out of their kids' magic set plastic version of that.
Yeah, I know.
Magic sets. If they do pull out a plastic version of this out of their kids' magic set, they'll be like, hang on a minute, how the hell was he doing because the routine with this is amazing. It's not just like a little rubbishy paddle thing. Here's some of the stuff you can do with it, right? You can draw red dots all over it on both sides and it looks amazing. Look, I'm going to wipe off one red dot, now it comes back, now I'm going to wipe off two red dots, now there's four, now there's six, boom, now there's a sponge ball, boom, now there's another sponge ball. Boom! Here's another one. You walk up to somebody you've never met before.
Was Jay Sankey
before
a minute, was he?
Well,
I'm buying my Christmas crackers next week. It's July.
Of course you are. He's getting excited about Christmas already. Look, here's another one. You walk up to a table, you've never met somebody before. Look, I'm going to write something down on here.
You're giving this as a something boom, down. This is brilliant. You're on about the name routine, yeah?
Yeah.
I think that presentation tips the method. When I think people have got a half. Maybe it's different in the UK, I don't know, but I think punters have got a bit of an expectation about how this actually works. I think it's slightly public domain in Britain, I think. And when he does the sort of your name, he writes your name, and then he erases a bit of the Y, and the same thing happens on the other side, I think it just tips the method, actually. And then, yeah, their name then appears on it at the end, but I don't know. I don't think it looks as nice as I'll Start Again, which was out years ago. A friend of mine, Ken Hawes, used to do with the actual mini blackboard with the chalk.
Which and I think,
I think it was a Ken Brook effect, and it looked more organic, whereas this actually looks like a plastic toy. Yeah. That's what I'm saying is wrong with it, in my mind.
The routines are good for me.
The routines are good. We're not. But I'll Start Again, or I'll Do It Again with the chalkboard was always a great routine. People may have forgotten about it. He may have modernized it, but for me, it's just taking away that earthiness to it. I don't like it as much as you do, but I think that's because I work in totally different environments. If this suits you, If this suits you, then the magic that you do with this is very strong. If this suits you.
Hmm. I agree.
Not me.
If it suits you, and that's all I'm trying to say. There's people out there that will be looking at this and they haven't got the same problems with it as you have. And for those people, if you look, Dave's going to have been dropping clips on the show. You're going to have seen how visual this is. If not, click onto World Magic Shop, search for this thing and watch the trailer. If you like it and you think, I don't care if this looks a little bit like a toy, I think this will work for the places that I perform in, then great, go for it. Because you know what? That's all you have to carry in a little pen and you're good to go.
How much are you going to give it?
I'm going to give it 70%.
Oh, I thought
reason,
you...
I'm not going to use it.
I thought you were going to say 90.
Because I'm not going to use it. But there's going to be lots of people out there that are. I think if you like the look of this, then great, go for it. Just because we don't think it would work for us, or Dave doesn't think it would work for him, doesn't mean that it's not going to work for a lot of people out there.
Yeah, I love Richard Sanders. I love his stuff, but I don't love this at all. I really do hate this, actually. I think as a professional, you should be doing stronger magic than a toy shop paddle.
As a professional
at the table.
Corporate worker.
Yeah, but it's my opinion. I can only give this like 50%. It's good what he does with it, but I just don't like it. I don't like it. It grates on me. I don't want to be seen in public with one of those things in my hand.
But the
like
coffee
this.
Cup, you're fine with that.
Yeah, that's all
you're
right.
You're fine with the coffee cup. The coffee cup get 99%.
I did say on the show last week that I would do that at home.
And have
not
you?
On about doing it in the real world.
So will you have this at home?
No. Oh, I won't. I don't want to be seen with that.
Someone comes around
not
your house.
At all.
Someone comes around your house. Yeah. You got a choice of doing the coffee cup thing or that. You'd rather do the
John,
coffee cup.
John, come on. What is it?
John,
coffee cup
John,
every time.
John, help me out here.
That's it this week for the Wizard Product
Even
Review.
Even John's not backing you up now.
That's it this week for the Wizard Product Review. I'm sorry, I don't like it, Richard.
I want a debate on Facebook. I think I can win this one. That's why you don't want it. Right, John, set up a debate. I guarantee you more people will back me up on this.
What's the debate? What's the question? Does this look like toy shop magic, yes or no? Right, there's your question. That's it this week for the Wizard Product Review. I'm Dave.
I'm Craig.
See you next week.